Hallo, herzlich willkommen und einen regnerischen Sonntagvormittag, bald schon Mittag und Nachmittag. Ganz einfach aus diesem Grunde, ich spiele wieder Sherlock Holmes, Crimes and Punishments. Zurzeit eigentlich mein absolutes Lieblingsspiel, sei es wegen den Rätseln, wegen der Handlung, auch wegen dem Fakt, dass ich sowieso ein riesen Sherlock Holmes Fan bin und die Adaption im Spiel, sei es auch mit einer englischen Audioausgabe, ziemlich gut gemacht ist und ich trotz all dem, wie die Resonanzen, Rezeption, wie auch immer sind, ich quasi kaum Klicks darauf habe, trotzdem dieses Spiel einfach mal machen werde, weil einfach so das Konzept an sich, das Spiel an sich mir einfach extrem viel Spaß macht. Ja, wir befinden uns gleich hier im dritten Fall, gleich geht's auch hier weiter. Machen wir erstmal fortfahren. Der dritte Fall, den wir jetzt hier machen werden, ist das Blutbad. Und ja, vorgestern habe ich das Rätsel um den verschwundenen Zug oder das Rätsel auf den Gleisen gelöst und von Fall zu Fall macht es immer mehr Spaß, gerade auch weil das der letzte Fall mir gar nicht so bekannt war. Ich bin davon ausgegangen, dass es was ganz anderes ist, ein Fall, den man sonst so aus den Audios und Filmen und Büchern kennt, aber dem war nicht so gewesen. Und ich werde jetzt einfach das Spiel jetzt hier mal laufen lassen, weil ich denke mal, es wird ein kleines Intro kommen zum jetzigen Fall. Das Blutbad will es eigentlich gar nicht so richtig großartig verpassen, aber ich werde mal ganz kurz verschwinden und mir was zum Essen und zum Trinken holen. Von daher, schaut mal kurz zu, viel Spaß damit und bis gleich.
Holmes!
I feel deathly.
And you look it. Let me examine you. Please don't tell me that you've returned to your old habits.
Oh, das geht ja jetzt hier schnell los. Da kommt das hier irgendwie eine kleine Vorgeschichte.
The pupil is dilated.
Ich denke mal eher, dass der Holmes wahrscheinlich Langeweile besitzt.
The temperature appears to be normal. I need to concentrate and count the heartbeats. I need to concentrate and count the heartbeats. Weak pulse, around 50 beats per minute.
Er ist halt tiefenentspannt, er überlegt.
But you're dying, Holmes. Your pulse rate is dropping. We need to get you to the hospital immediately.
The antidote. Give it to me.
The antidote? You mean that you're poisoned?
Now. Please.
Here, drink it all. Don't tell me that you did this to yourself.
Hemlock and Datura. I was compelled to.
Holmes, imagine if I'd not returned home when I did. What might have happened?
I knew that you would.
Mr. Holmes, Inspector Lestrade is here to see you.
Mr. Holmes is unable to see anyone at the moment. He is unwell.
A good day, Inspector.
Ah, Mr. Holmes, I'm glad to find you here. I need your help. This is a strange one. We have brought in two young bankers from the city, sons of lords, members of the chamber, and so on and so forth. They were found stranded in a rowing boat that was drifting on the Thames.
A romantic escapade with an unhappy ending, Lestrade.
What? Well, yes, they were both in the bath, but what?
As I said.
And they were tied together.
You are lacking in imagination, Inspector.
Well, no, I'm not. Anyway, there was a banner flapping about in the boat with the RMS Oceanic printed on it and signed by the Merry Men.
The Oceanic? Isn't that the largest steamer ever built?
Yes. And these two young banker chaps are sons of the owners of the White Star Line, the company that built it. There are rumors of corruption.
I'm not interested in politics, Lestrade.
I'll keep it then. Here's another one that's a bit more complex and maybe to your liking. It's a murder, but we're unable to find any weapon. We haven't touched anything. It's at the Roman Baths in Strand Lane.
A murder, a vanishing weapon, the Roman Baths. That's for us. Watson, fetch your hat.
Gucken wir uns unsere Trophäen jetzt hier mal an. Eine Dampfpfeife, wie sie in Zügen verwendet wird. Das ist unsere Trophäe vom letzten Fall. Und es geht einfach zum nächsten Fall über. Ein mysteriöser Mord ohne Tatwaffe in römischen Thermen.
Beautiful place.
With a dreadful murder. The body of Sir Rodney Bentcliffe is still in the steam room. It has not been touched, per your usual instructions, Mr. Holmes. I shall be waiting for you here, but please hurry.
Was gibt es denn für Verdächtige?
Are you able to identify the men who were with the victim in the steam room?
Yes. The manager of the bath, Sir Gregory Pitkin, a lad from the city council, Garrow, and an archaeologist by the name of Blinkhorn. I think the plump one, Garrow, did it. He doesn't seem right in the head.
Well, we shall see.
Die Tatwaffe.
You found no murder.
Die ja nicht gefunden wurde.
No, and that's why I called you. All three witnesses and the victim were locked in when the murder occurred, and they remained so until we got here. We even had to pick the lock to enter.
I see. Was there anyone else here? Apart from those gentlemen in the steam room.
Yes, a Mr. Phillips. He was the one who called the police. He will be able to give you more details.
Dann reden wir gleich schon mit ihm hier.
Any progress, Mr. Holmes?
Good day to you, Mr. Phillips. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my colleague, Dr. Watson. Would you be so kind as to answer our questions?
Certainly, sir.
So, mit wem haben wir es hier zu tun? Leichte Falten. Oh, der Mund. Gut, leichte Falten, Manchester City, glänzende Knöpfe, Penibel lebt alleine und ein heute aufgegebenes Telegramm. Also, was ist geschehen?
Please tell us the chain of events from the start of your day. Everything that you can remember. The slightest detail may be of importance.
Very well, sir. I came in at 6:30 this morning and I opened the baths. I made sure that the room was clean and I prepared the towels. The brazier was still burning.
There was a fire burning all night.
Yes, Sir Gregory ordered me to light the brazier yesterday. It takes some time until the room is fully heated. The gentleman had a meeting at 9 o'clock this morning. I wanted everything to be perfect. They'd been in the steam room for 20 minutes when I suddenly heard shouting. I ran to the door, but it was closed. I couldn't open it. So I ran out to the street to call for the police. One constable came up, and then there were others, and they picked the lock. Then Inspector Lestrade came along, and he told us that nothing should be touched.
Naja, immerhin etwas.
Did you receive any other visitors this morning?
No one. Until these gentlemen arrived. Sir Gregory was the first. And then, while we were discussing work details, Sir Rodney and Mr. Blinkhorn arrived, and Mr. Garrow followed.
What happened after that?
I waited until they'd all entered the steam room, then I returned to the hall. The changing room door was open, so I should hear if they needed anything.
You would have heard if someone had entered or left the steam room.
Certainly, sir. These doors make a lot of noise.
Gut, also, drei Zeugen. Befragen wir mal die anderen.
What should we do next, Holmes?
Wir fragen jetzt hier erstmal den, den wir befragen können.
Any progress, Mr. Holmes?
Expensive clothes, belonging to one of the men from the steam room. Champagne, for a special occasion. Unopened, it was intended to be enjoyed after the steam session.
Mm-hmm.
An ice bucket. To keep the champagne chilled.
Also wollte sich irgendjemand nach dem Dampfbad noch mit irgendwem vielleicht gemütlich machen.
These clothes belong to one of the suspects from the steam room. Clothes belonging to one of the suspects.
Oh, da haben wir auch schon gleich die Leiche.
Death with a peculiarly Roman piquancy.
Like the one you almost had an hour ago.
Let us forget about that.
Was stehen die hinter uns noch rum? Untersuchen wir ihn erstmal hier. So. Das Gesicht ist ja mit am auffälligsten von allen.
It pierced the right eye straight through to the brain. Death would have been instantaneous.
The wound should not have bled so profusely. This pool is rather large. Some dirt or earth. I'll take a sample.
Well, death is very recent, between 30 minutes to 1 hour ago.
Oh.
Look, Watson. He was wearing a ring. He very likely removed it before the steam session. I think we have found all that we can here, taking into consideration the abysmal lighting. Constable, we have finished with the body.
We don't have many leads here.
What concerns me is that we still have to find the murder weapon.
Mr. Holmes?
Please have the body removed without disturbing anything else in the room.
All right, Mr. Holmes.
I was wondering, Holmes, it's fairly reckless to carry out a murder inside a closed chamber. Why do you suppose they did it?
There are a great many possibilities. The murderer was in a hurry. Or he is an artist. Or a ghost. Or he wanted to ensure that I'd be brought in on the case.
Probably the latter. You are ridiculous, do you know that?
So, was macht ihr hier eigentlich?
I'm in shock.
Dann geht doch raus. Oh.
Blood traces wiped on the towel.
It's horrible.
It's horrible. I can't talk at the moment.
Warum?
I found him. I touched his shoulder.
The brazier is still burning. The heat here is extreme. It is too hot. I cannot reach into it. I will need something to pick up this melted metal. With the steam on, I'm unable to see even a few feet away.
So, jetzt brauche ich hier irgendwas. Ah, die Brille kann ich wenigstens anfassen. Oh.
One lens is cracked, probably due to the temperature of the brazier. These lenses are for myopia. The wearer is short-sighted.
Jetzt brauche ich auf alle Fälle irgendwas, um die Sachen da drin anzufassen.
I don't want to stay here.
Ja. Nö. Nope. Oh, die Blutlache können wir nochmal inspizieren.
I should check this blood sample at Baker Street.
Da ist noch nicht alles kontrolliert. Ja, doch. Ah!
This key was covered in blood. I should ask Phillips about it.
Was haben wir hier? Ein Gitter.
The grid cannot be removed. The weapon is nowhere to be found.
Die lassen sich.
I'm always wondering what's on your mind, Holmes.
Oh, einiges. Wir brauchen auf alle Fälle irgendwas. Um das da.
Mr. Holmes?
Da rauszuholen?
The brazier is still burning. The heat here is extreme. I will need something to pick up.
Okay. Dann machen wir uns mal auf die Suche nach dem Gegenstand und befragen gleich mal den Aufpasser, wie auch immer ihn nennen mag. Nach dem Schlüssel, den wir gefunden haben.
Mr. Holmes, I should like to take the suspects to the yard. You can interrogate them there. Any objections?
Please wait, I need to do something first.